Hello mga kapamilya! Happy New Year po sa inyong lahat. To start off the year with a bang, we offer you a treat. We have a Block Z exclusive today with none other than the award-winning director of Block Z himself, Direk Mikhail Red. Hello, Direk!
Hello, thank you for having me here.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
Kamusta naman ang celebration?
Okay naman. Nag-vacation naman. Pero now, it's promo time.
Back to work. Yes. Yeah. So, this film, Block Z, kailan yun natapos gawin ito? And how many days did it take you to film everything?
I think 2 years ago, na-pitch na yung idea na. We wanted to make like a big zombie movie set in the Philippines. You know, it's already a genre that's been explored. But I've never seen like a big studio version of it na pwedeng panoorin ng wide audience dito. So, na-excite ako na nagka-opportunity ako to make a zombie movie. Kasi pangarap ko talaga gumawa ng zombie movie. High school pa lang.
Talaga?
Gumagawa na ako ng mga zombie movies with my classmates.
Bakit sa lahat zombie lang movie? Parang hindi usual yun. Kasi madalas rom-com, diba? O comedy.
Pero yun yung exciting. Parang finally meron kaming project na medyo kakaiba. And even for the cast, kaya sila na-excite working on this. Na-showcase namin yung versatility nila. And nakatry sila na, in a way, parang nagfulfill ng lifelong fantasy. Not everyone gets the chance to do a zombie movie. So kami tinodo talaga na. 30 shooting days, we wrapped up mga June, July, and then siyempre, dahil zombie movie, matagal lang yung post-production process.
Para po sa inyong kaalaman mga kapamilya, ito si Direk Mikhail Red is also the award-winning director for Eerie and Birdshot. So yung Birdshot, ito yung na-stream sa Netflix, tama ba?
Yeah, it's the first, we're lucky na it was the first Filipino film na na-pick up ng Netflix for international streaming and local streaming. And then recently, we also did Dead Kids, the first Netflix original movie.
Oh, okay.
It was available.
Grabe yung Eerie, ah. Gusto ko lang sabihin sa'yo, Direk, talagang I was like clinging on to my seat for the whole movie. Hindi ako makampante kasi nga feeling ko anytime may mangyayari. Yun din ba yung may experience namin dito sa Block Z?
In a way, mayroon mga scares ang Block Z. Pero ang exciting sa Block Z, hindi lang siya scares kasi Eerie, mas ano siya yun, spiritual horror. Yung Block Z, roller coaster ride. May iba-ibang emotions na feel kasi mas thrilling siya. Takbuhan, habulan,
how is this patayan different from the other zombie films that we've watched?
Well, ito mas focus sa barkada. Kasi parang barkada experience to. So I encourage like young people to watch it more than once. Watch it multiple times. Kasi yung Block Z is about what if sa university nyo, biglang nagka-zombie outbreak, tapos na-quarantine kayo. So bawal kayo lumabas, trapped kayo. And you have to survive and parang rely on each other and yung friendship nyo to make it
kung out. Kung malakas ang friendship nyo, exactly. Matibay.
So it's the perfect barkada movie. So I encourage you guys to just, you know, enjoy and have fun.
Okay, how was it working with a younger cast? Because, you know, you came from Eerie, working with Bea Alonzo, working with Ma'am Charo Santos Concho. Now, you have the younger actors and actresses. You have Joshua Garcia, Julia Barreto,
si Makoy
De Leon, yes.
Even Marisa Calis. Uh-huh.
So how was it working with a younger crew? What can you say about them?
Super fun kasi nga, para kayong real-life barkada rin. And, you know, as a millennial myself, parang ang exciting lang na you get to make the films na you've always wanted to see on the big screen. So parang it's, for me, it's a movie na really geared towards that type of audience. So ang perfect lang ng chemistry in a way.
Did you act like a mentor for them or nagbigay ka ba ng tips? Paano yung dynamic ninyo?
Syempre parang lagi kami nagka-cast bonding para lang maayos yung chemistry. Like, even outside set, minsan gigimmick kami.
So, iilan kayo sa grupo?
Iba-iba eh. Syempre, lahat ng, yung younger teenage cast. Mm-hmm. And meron rin adult characters. Nandito rin si Dimples Romano and Ian Veneracion.
Okay.
Syempre, may security guard, si Dimples Romano ng campus. And then may parent, dad, si Ian Veneracion.
So, parang sumasama rin sila pumarty?
Oo, syempre. Lahat naman hip. And yun yung masaya sa set. Like, we play music. We ang daming banter, ang daming jokes. Mm-hmm. We just have fun with it. It's a zombie movie. So, yung objective dito, like, minsan lang mangyari. So, we really took advantage of that opportunity and enjoyed the process. Kasi, kakaiba siya eh. You don't get to do this every day. It's not your usual genre na ginagawa ng local scene.
So, ito yung hindi nakikita ng audience, ano, yung bonding and yung chemistry. Parang ano rin yan eh, parang sports that you need to gel with each other to bring out the best in each other. But, you know, is there anybody who stood out or like anything that you noted from these actors and actresses?
Yeah, ayoko naman mag, like, maging too specific kasi everyone did their part. I think yun yung maganda sa movie na to. Parang every character is different. Yeah. Kasi like I said...
Like ito na lang, yung mga hindi mo makalimutan na, ah, ganito pala, sige nito. Ah, ayan.
Well, buwan yung ano... Well, there was this fight scene na parang nagulat ako na everyone, they were willing to do their own stunts. Yeah. Kasi we had doubles. Pero kasi parang nag-enjoy sila eh. They like hitting the zombies. Ganun. So everyone parang nagulat ako na
hitting ganun, the zombies, like these zombies were real people.
Meron kaming stunts. Like they're used to getting hit. So may stunts kami and prosthetics. And they, parang they insisted on doing it themselves, yung mga actors. And ang interesting nun, kasi nga, you see siguro na this is something that they've also dreamed of doing. I'm sure they've, you know, they've done their roles nga sa mga dramatic films nila or romantic films. Pero parang, finally we get to do a zombie movie. So, dito nila tinode. And yun, nagulat ako na, yun, they were all parang enthusiastic.
What's the most difficult part about crafting a horror film?
Well, for me, the challenge here is, even though we've done zombie movies in the past, no, parang this is the first time na parang, I think by Star Cinema, na aiming for a wide audience. So, in a way, we were working on this, but all our references are foreign movies, no? Are big, you know, Hollywood zombie movies. So, parang the challenge was, how do you translate it here for a local audience? And syempre, iba pa rin resources na rin, hindi naman tayo Hollywood. So parang, how do you do that creatively and still make it fun? So yun, me and my team, you know, we really worked hard on this.
How did you balance that? To still make it local at the same time, perfect for the international scene?
Yun nga, ako maswerte na yung background ko is independent filmmaking. So nasanay ako working with very constrained budgets, and I always say na sometimes when you think inside the box, yung parameters can make you more creative. So literally, they're inside the box. Mm-hmm. That's the first step we did. No script pa lang, let's contain it, diba? Parang it happens in a university, diba? It's ordinary day, classes have started, yun. And then all of a sudden, nag-sound yung alarm, kala mo earthquake drill na naman, yun. Classes are suspended kasi may zombies, and then you have to survive. So yung setting pa lang helps us parang contain it and still make it exciting, diba? It adds that pressure na you're walled in. Pero it helps us with the scale, diba? We're not like, you know, burning the whole city down. So, and dahil school setting, all the other zombies are also students, diba? So here you'll see cheerleader zombies, yung mascot ng basketball team na zombie, jock zombies, nerd zombies. Parang nandun lahat ng archetypes na you would see na in a school movie.
Pinakamahirap pa sa lahat ng films na ginawa mo.
I would say, they're labeling it as one of my more ambitious projects. Kasi it's true. Like, in terms of number of shooting days and budget, of course, it's bigger. There's more characters, more extras, you know, the stars are bigger. And imagine mo, like, directing a crowd of zombies. You know, each zombie, kailangan ng prosthetic. Diba? For prosthetic, and then yung iba stunts. And then kailangan mo i-block lahat yun. And then, imagine mo like an attack scene sa classroom, maduduguan, tutumba yung chairs. Paano ka magte-take two, diba? Reset mo lahat yun. Do a take two. So, it's time-consuming and challenging. Pero, yun nga, we like to challenge ourselves. We like to do things na no one has done yet.
Para pala siyang action plus horror.
Action plus horror plus barkada. Tapos may mga quips din, so may konting humor.
All of those elements.
Yeah, medyo light pa rin siya. So, yun, very, very genre siya. It's a roller coaster movie. Yeah.
Let's get to know a different side of you, Direk. I mean, you are 28 years old, you mentioned. but you've managed to win awards from all over the world. And yung mga films mo talagang, you know, they really made waves in the Philippine cinema scene. How does it feel, you know, to be achieving all of this at a young age?
Yun, parang a lot of people think na, I got all of this instantly, but actually, I've been doing this for quite a while. I was just lucky that I started young. So I started when I was a teenager making short films. So if you really count those years, it took me more than a decade to finally
break it. You started at what age?
I was 15 years old when I made my first serious short film and it got into film festivals. And from there, it's really, you know, just taking that leap. Parang for me, filmmaking has always been like a calling. It's like a mindset na it takes so much willpower and passion to just go out and shoot a movie that no one asked for. So when I was a kid, you know, it wasn't a homework, it wasn't a project, but I would shoot movies, you know, on a small camera with friends. You know, I would show it to other friends, and you get to learn and enjoy the process. So, yeah, I got obsessed with it from a hobby, naging career. I was lucky I got into Cinemalaya. So I started very independent, no? Very art house yung roots. I did experimental films, festivals. And then later on, I tried to do genre naman to parang challenge myself, try something different. Like, iba kasi yung genre and in a way, making movies na studio kasi may objectives ka. Diba, you're trying to reach a wide audience, you're making sure na, you know, it's commercially successful, but at the same time, it's still fun and creative. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So yeah, I tried that. So after doing my first few films na grant-funded and festivals na usually pinipitch namin abroad, I worked naman with Star Cinema, I did a movie with Globe Studios.
Kumbaga parang ang dami mo ng bangkong experience.
Yeah, parang yun. Parang it's about, siguro maybe I also have like a producer's hat sometimes, uh-huh. So I want to try different distribution models then. So we did straight to streaming, mm-hmm. with Dead Kids, we did like studio funded movie like Eerie and Block Z. I also did films that grant funded. So yeah, parang siguro yung philosophy ko is siguro parang every greenlit project is an opportunity to try new things, to learn. I still consider myself pang a student then of, mm-hmm. filmmaking. So, ang exciting lang na every movie I get to make, I make sure I'm doing something new as a filmmaker. So I wanna try new treatment, new equipment, new camera movements.
What's
new
the
genres.
Influence of your family in this? Because you were born into a family of filmmakers. Si Direk Raymond Red, yeah. Your father won a Palme d'Or.
Yeah, 2000.
2000. Yeah. You have your brother, siblings also?
Yeah, he's my younger brother is also, mm-hmm. an editor and a scriptwriter. My cousin is also a director and a writer. So yeah, I was...
How do you like, how do you support each other? And, you know, with your father, does he tell you how to do a film? What is his influence in your life and your style of filmmaking?
Siguro I was really lucky na dahil artists rin yung parents ko. I was exposed to cinema very early on. Pero I was lucky na they never parang forced me or pushed me. Now they let me discover it on my own. They let me develop my own voice. So even me and my dad, medyo iba yung style namin, iba yung films namin. He used to do mga historical epics. He did like Bayani Sakay, he did Super 8 experimental films. And you know, we discuss about, you know, cinema and films a lot. We watch a lot of films together. Pero we make sure not to parang be too involved with each other's projects. Like he, I was lucky that he let me, you know, make my own films and grow on my own. He was never on set. Siguro the only time he would get involved is when he would see like a rough cut and minsan kailangan mo papilitin na panoorin niya.
Ayaw niya makialam.
Oh, parang ganun. And even naman, like, for example, when my cousin also did her first feature film, you know, she did it independently. Parang we try to give each other space, but at the same time, sometimes we collaborate. Like, mm-hmm. my younger brother, nga, he knows me, he knows my taste. You know, we grew up together, so we watch the same films, same pegs and references. So, okay siya as an editor, kasi, you know, I can just make a mouth, a sound effect, gets na niya yung cut, diba? And I can reference a certain film. Alam kong napanood niya, kasi we watch the same films. So, effective editor siya for me. He co-wrote Dead Kids. Yung cousin ka naman co-wrote Eerie, mm-hmm. and Birdshot, mm-hmm. so. It's
what
nice
what kind
them.
Of films do you want to produce? I mean, there's a Mikhail Red trademark in all of the films, what could it be?
Ako right now, parang na-notice ko, maybe subconsciously, hindi naman siguro deliberate, na most of my films, I like using genre as parang a vehicle or packaging.
So para maintindihan siguro ng mga tao, ano ibig sabihin ng genre?
Genre.
Kasi yung genre film.
Siguro like thriller, horror, mga ganyan.
Kumbaga naka-box siya into a genre.
Hindi siya yung isa pa, mas conventional na, let's say, drama or yeah, mostly drama naman yung parang mas serious films or diba? There's
iba
more art house na mas pang niche audience, diba? Medyo mas sophisticated, gano'n. Ako ay like using conventional genre, like parang may parameters ang genre.
Okay, so genre, ganun, parang may parameters. And then gusto mo na lang nilalaro yung elements. Is that it?
Yeah, parang may conventions ang genre na. There's objectives, there's rules to it. Uh-huh. Sa structure and yung elements. So horror has certain elements and has certain language, but thrillers. So parang it kind of parang guides you and at the same time it challenges you kasi nga may parameters. But I use that as like a vehicle, no? To reach a wide audience, mm-hmm, pero lagi kaming may kahit paano may social relevance inside of that. So it's more accessible. Mm-hmm. Parang if you have a message na you want, you know, people to in a way digest. You make it easier for them rin by using genre sa surface. So you have like an entertaining layer pero engaging
and relatable layer and then meron kang
engaging yung subtext. Uh-huh. Parang nga siyang Trojan horse. Yun.
Oh.
Or veggie meat. Parang ganun eh. Parang you're just making
hindi halata.
You're making it easy.
Masimple lang.
So they're enjoying themselves and it's a more sustainable ano rin. In a way, model. Kasi
it's how you balance the indie side with the mainstream side.
Na-encourage yung studios to keep investing if it's sustainable. Kasi, you know, if people watch it, it makes money. But at the same time, you're slowly growing their taste. Kaysa biglain mo agad ng something too heavy.
Bakit
but that's just me.
Bakit mo nakahiligan yung ganitong klaseng film? Parang medyo yung nakakatakot, ano? Suspense.
Oh yeah, mga
suspense. Diba parang yung Birdshot, Eerie, and then this one. They're all a little bit dark.
Can I describe
it that way?
Bakit mga ba? I don't know, siguro influences ko rin. Very, napapanood ko mga foreign movies, Western influences ko. Ganun. Lagi may angst, diba? May galit sa mundo. But I still try to make it fun. Mm-hmm. Like, mm-hmm. Block Z has moments of humor, for example. May barkada element. Dead Kids. May black comedy siya, di ba? Parang satire siya. So we use humor, pero slowly nag-shift rin yung tone, nagiging seryoso. So ganun, parang we try to capture the audience first and before we bring them to yung sinasabi yung message.
Speaking of the message, you know, what kind of message is this film trying to portray? I mean, the most that you can tell us, of course. And is it, you know, parang how does it relate to the Philippine context? Mm. Is it unity in times of crisis?
It's exactly that. In fact, yun yung mga nasa tagline. It's about unity. It's about surviving together. Kasi parang yung point is, in times of crisis, parang do we lose our humanity? Diba? Do we become selfish and just focus on our own survival? Or do we work together to get through a calamity? And I think it's a very Filipino trait. No? Kasi archipelago tayo. So parang geographically, we're all separated. Diba? Iba-ibang language pa nga. And yet, we survive together. We're very clannish. Diba? We like to... We're resilient. Diba? We get hit by typhoons, diba? Every year. Baka may political differences tayo. And yet, we're still very proud as a country. And as a family unit, diba? Very important in sa Pinoy. Family unit and yung clan. So I think yun yung very Filipino about Block City. It starts off, syempre, may conflict, may crisis, may konting differences tayo, mahirap mag-get along. And we're all individuals, iba-ibang personality traits like a barkada or minsan may rift between parent and child. Pero because nga we realize na there's no way we're gonna get out of this alive on our own. we learn to work together and to make sacrifices together.
Ano dapat namin dalin pag pinanood namin tong Black Z?
Your friends.
Ayun, yun, yun na yun.
And then,
okay na yun, sapat na.
Sabihin ko, like, watch it with a group of friends and then watch it with your family. And then pag alam nyo na kung saan yung mga scares, yung second viewing nyo, tingnan nyo yung mga katabi niya, check nyo yung reaction. So watch it multiple times.
What's next for you? You know, anything that we should watch out for?
Right now, I'm shooting the first Philippine set HBO series. So it's my first time trying a longer format, no? Mini series.
Wow.
So, yeah, exciting. Yeah.
Are you the first one to achieve this kind?
I think mini series. I think Eric Mati did like an anthology episode for Food Lore. But this is the first Filipino mini-series.
Ang galing.
So it's exciting kasi bagong format siya. So I do feature.
How do you feel about all of this success?
Tarang, I just keep busy.
Kinakabahan ka ba pagka?
Of course, syempre, it's always challenging. Pero I think the trick is to just keep focused sa work and just always set new goals. And as long as you're always trying new things and you're always outside your comfort zone, but
and it's not easy to fail in Philippine cinema because there's so much at stake.
Yeah.
There's budget.
Yeah.
The trust of your sponsors, your credibility also, your reputation, tiwala sa yung mga actors, you know. What's been, you know, your biggest failure in this 13-year journey that you've been doing film?
Siguro ano, I need to be more patient sometimes. Maybe, you know, I get too excited. Kasi I enjoy the process talaga. They always say, you know, filmmaking is
suffering. Pwede mo naman, paano yung process? Puyat-puyat ka ba?
In a
kasi
way,
yung ano namin eh, depiction namin sa mga director.
Ito, lalo na dito, di ba? Parang, dahil nga mas may budget constraints, you have to, you know, do extra work. Pero, yun, siguro when it gets tough, I always try to go back and remember why I started. And, you know, these things I'm doing now are things that I've only dreamt of before. So when it gets hard, parang I just think about that. Na, finally, I'm here, I'm doing it on a bigger scale, so might as well just push further. Konti na lang, matatapos na to. And just make sure you have a good film. And even if it, you know, doesn't turn out the way you want it, you always learn something from it and you carry on sa next project mo. And as long as you're challenging yourself, no, hindi ka mag-stagnate as an artist. Lagi kang may next level na gusto i-reach. So ngayon, I'm trying to focus then on English language work. You know, HBO series, di ba, medyo English language rin siya. Majority ng language in English. I recently got US representation, so now they're sending US scripts, you know, we're exploring that. And yeah, so we're working on
so wala ka pang film na hindi kumikita?
It depends sa context na kasi some are, again, grant-funded.
Okay.
So, yung mga ganun kasi,
hindi profit-oriented.
Parang it's for the prestige and to build your career. And because it's a competitive grant na you win by pitching a good story, a good script, there's no obligation to return that money. No? Hindi naman sila in it for business. It's like an award. So yung mga movies din, parang they don't necessarily have to earn.
You get your feet wet also in different channels.
Ang galing rin eh, na nagiging aware ka rin as a filmmaker of how that works. You know, it's not just an art form, there's a science to it. And if you learn that, you get to be more, at least conscious, di ba? And you get to have more control siguro sa project na kasi you know the objective. Parang ganyan, hindi ka lang naka-focus sa, I mean, syempre, yun yung number one. You make a good film, focus ka sa creative aspects. Pero if you have that producer mindset, then you can turn your calling into a career. Parang ganun, yeah. Make it sustainable.
Make it sustainable.
Para you don't have to do anything else but make films. Yun naman yung
balance.
Yun yung dream.
Finding the balance.
And syempre, producer studios and people who greenlight projects, they like to work with filmmakers who are, you know, responsible and with the investment. Parang ganun. Parang, you know, you're aware of what you're trying to do. Hindi ka lang too focused on like yung creative aspect pero nane-neglect mo parang paano mo ba ito madidistribute? Paano ito papanoorin ng tao? Diba? Sana may ganun ka rin na conscious ka, may plano ka.
Saan nagagaling yung grit na to, yung maturity na to? I mean, you're very young. And one interesting fact is, pwede ka ba sabihin that you did not finish college, di ba? Tama ko, sa Ateneo ka din, one big fight. You did one SEM with Ateneo, dropped out, and continued on filmmaking, pursuing it at a very young age. Did that in any way help you form you as a director now?
Siguro, parang it's weird eh. Parang it kind of forces you into a corner and gives you only one option. Parang ganun eh. By doing that, you have no choice but for it to work. I think that's, maybe I'm a frustrated startup CEO. Parang ganun, it's napunta ako sa arts. So parang may ganun kang mindset na you quit school, go to a garage, and you have to make sure this works.
Parang otherwise, si Steve Jobs, diba ganun? Parang ganun, hindi sila nakapagtapos ng college, diba?
And even ngayon eh, parang ang daming startups na ganun. Parang your whole life, you're just pushing on one thing and hoping it works. And dahil sobrang linear mo mag-isip, nagkakaroon ng parang inevitability. Parang ganun. It's either, yeah, you make it or you don't. Parang bahala na, you jump.
Si Steve Jobs ba o si Mark Zuckerberg? Mark Zuckerberg.
Actually, marami.
Marami nga sila, marami.
Parang ganun eh, kasi napipilitan ka. Dahil wala kang safety.
Yeah.
Parang kung tinanggal mo yung safety rope, mas malayo yung talon.
And that's where the grit comes
siguro,
from.
Siguro, parang ganun. You're always aiming for the bullseye. Hindi ka, yeah, whatever it hits. Parang ganun. Parang meron kang target talaga. So, I guess that's what helped me make sure na, parang I'm always deliberate. Ganun. I'm always conscious, self-aware.
What's your vision for yourself? The big dream?
I wanna do bigger films then. Kasi, you know, I've tried naman doing more personal work. I alternate naman. I do a studio film sometimes. I'm developing right now another more personal film. Pero at the same time, I wanna try bigger movies. Like, I want, you know, more CGI, more bigger sets, more scale.
More international also.
That's why, yun, I'm really pushing itong parang US track. That's why we got, I was lucky that after Birdshot and Eerie, may kinuha ko ng 3 Arts and now Paradigm.
Is there bigger demand now for more local content? Content coming from, you know, like Philippines, for example, sa international market?
Yep. It's interesting that they're consciously trying to diversify. No? And then after Bong Joon-ho's big win, na isa rin sa idols ka, like Birdshot, was kind of inspired by his film Memories of Murder. No? But he says na, you know, you have to get through that 1-inch barrier of subtitles. It opens you up to a whole new world of, you know, cinema.
What does that mean exactly?
Parang he's telling us, you know, it's not just Hollywood. Parang ganun. There's international films out there. There are so many great films. Which, in turn, parang tells US producers to start looking for, ano, for foreign content and foreign
so there's
talent.
There's a lot more opportunities coming.
So nag-i-import sila ng directors, diba, to do big films there, or sometimes they remake films there.
How does this change the local dynamic? I mean, has it become more collaborative? Parang ikaw, pwede ka mag-work with other directors and
nakikita ko, slowly, nag-open up nga yung studio sa genre. Like you would, diba, finally may zombie movie. Eerie was a international co-production. So parang they're starting to see
experiment.
Yeah, outside that bubble. Kasi I mean, we already have the formula to make it in that bubble. We know how to target yung
mainstream.
Oh, masa, Filipino, diba? We have that track record. Pero to make bigger films, you need to sustain it with more audience na hindi naman kaya ng middle class lang ng Philippines.
So in effect, the whole world is your competition now.
Yeah, parang ganun. There's more filmmakers every year. Accessible na dahil sa technology. So it's now about yung voice mo and siguro yung taste mo. Kasi yun naman yung talent ng director.
Okay, so with that, what's your advice to young aspiring filmmakers who probably, you know, they're just waiting for a big break or don't have the courage to come out or nag-iisip pa ng big idea. Ano yung masasabi mo sa kanila?
Ako, tingin ko talaga ang kailangan nyo lang kwento at camera. Kailangan nyo lang tumalon and go do it. Filmmaking is a mindset. So if you're a filmmaker, you don't even need me to tell you. It's that urge to tell stories visually, no matter what. Don't let anyone stop you kahit sarili mo. So just go out there. You know, shoot a film, make micro-budget short films with your friends, upload it on YouTube. learn to enjoy the process. And then from there, magiging ano na yan eh, instinct na lang yan.
Do you think anybody can be a filmmaker now?
Yes, you can shoot a film with your cell phone and parang cinema is everywhere. It's an LED billboard.
What's the difference between a YouTube vlog and a film?
Para sa akin, it's all cinema. It's all moving images and visual storytelling. You can tell a story with your vlog, diba? There's that conscious decision to edit and to create that film language. So yeah, so if you can vlog, I think you can make a film. And dami nga nagta-transition from YouTube to feature filmmakers.
Wow.
So yun, it's easier now. So yung trick is to have an original voice. So make the film that only you can make.
Ganda. So, Direk, gusto na kita i-congratulate dahil bilang isang co-millennial mo, napaka-proud ko sa'yo.
thank you.
I mean, like, you know, you're younger than me by a year, but you've already achieved so much. And nakikita ko sa'yo yung hunger to do even more. And I can't wait to watch your films, upcoming films. Anything you'd like to invite us to?
Please, everyone, please watch Block Z, showing nationwide in cinemas January 29. It's a big Filipino zombie movie. So support nyo, manood kayo kasama ng barkada nyo, panoorin nyo paulit-ulit. And enjoy it kasi roller coaster ride siya. And minsan lang magka gantong zombie movie. And maraming surprises dyan sa film niya. So check nyo na lang. Tapos pag-usapan nyo online, social media, encourage
support
other people to watch.
Last na, may time ko pa ba sa love life?
Meron.
Okay. Okay. So posible pala, posible. Maging busy sa career. Tapos magka-love life. Pwede ba namin alam sino? wag na. Abangan nyo na lang.
Sige.
Maraming salamat, Direk.
Thank you.
Manood po kayo ng Block Z. Thank you so much for this Block Z exclusive. You can watch more on Star Cinema's Facebook page. Thank you so much.